And we're just touching base with you today. This is day one of quarantine, stay at home. And there are some who are out doing essential business. I guess we're one of those. We're a church. And I just wanted to send some words of encouragement to you. God is directing all of us and our country down a different path. We call that a detour. We don't always like those. If you look out the window here, we're in a prayer room here at the church. If you look out the room, you see the detour signs. And our church is at Broad and Wilson. And Wilson's going to be closed for 150 days. So there's some traffic coming by our church. We don't know what impact it'll have. But it is a detour, nonetheless. And we're facing that too. All of us are. And our country is responding and trying to take the necessary steps and measures to keep the coronavirus at bay. And so we're all praying that God will just keep us healthy. But we're also praying that God will just use this in all of our lives, that we'll have a witness and testimony, and the God in our personal lives. We'll just use it as an opportunity to grow. So today I just wanted to talk about that. When God does take us down a path, it's not always easy. It's not always something that we like. It often inconveniences us. But you know, think of some men and women in the scriptures. I think of Joseph, who for 13 years was taken from his family on a detour path, and suffered in that. And yet, at the end of the day, God used him to save and provide for his family. I think of Moses, who was in exile for 40 years, and during that time he grew and was prepared to be used of God. God used him then to deliver his people, Israel, from Egypt, from slavery. I think of Joseph and Caleb. You know, they in obedience said to the nation of Israel, "We can go into the promised land." And yet the people said, "No, we're not ready, we're afraid." And it was almost another 40 years that nation went on a detour because of that choice. Joshua and Caleb were affected by that. I think of Job. You know, Job lost everything. And so for a period of time, we don't know how long for sure, he only had three friends that were with him, and even four. And even they weren't really that close of friends, being to him what he really needed. And yet, at the end, God blessed him materially, but more than that, God blessed him spiritually and enriched his relationship with God. And Job was a different man as a result of that. We see Noah. You know, Noah worked on the ark. Most likely 120 years he did that. He probably maybe had a crew to help him, but that burden was his alone. And so for that whole time period, that's what he did. You could say he was almost quarantined to that project, and he was focused on that project. In obedience, he stepped onto the ark, and God saved him, his wife, and his family. And that was it. I think of John the Baptist. John the Baptist was exiled to Patmos because of his stand for Christ. And on that island, he suffered. On that island, it wasn't easy. It was a prison camp. And yet on that island was one of the richest blessings of his life. He met with the Lord, and he wrote the book of Revelation and was able to see what was coming as history unfolds. He's able to see things that even we don't. I want to go to Romans chapter 5 and just draw some encouragement from Paul. Paul writes these words in Romans 5. He says, "Therefore, since we have been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ." In that relationship, we are declared right with God. The result of that is we have peace with God. And that's because of faith in Christ. And in verse 2 he says, through Christ we have also obtained access by faith into this grace in which we stand. And we rejoice in the hope of the glory of God. That relationship with Christ brings hope, it brings joy, it brings the presence of God into our life. But here's the challenge. In that walk of faith, God takes us on a path that is often a detour in our mind and in our thinking, but never in God's mind. He always has a purpose and a plan. Verse 3 says this, "But not only that, we rejoice in our sufferings," or we rejoice in our trials and tribulations, or we rejoice in our detours that God takes us on. We're having to be home. We're not able to go out. We're not able to do things we normally do. Sports and all those extra things that are a part of our life are now taken away. And it's just us and our family and us and the ones who are closest to us and us and God. What are we going to do with this time? God says this detour in our life, in his hands, is productive and good. So let's continue on. He says, we rejoice in our sufferings because we know that our sufferings are detours, produce endurance. It produces perseverance in our walk. It gives us the opportunity to grow and to flex our spiritual muscles and to see God develop us and to make us stronger in Christ. That endurance, that perseverance, it produces character. It strengthens our heart. It strengthens our relationship with Christ. It strengthens our ability to see God by faith and to see that faith come alive each day as we practice obedience. And then that character produces hope. That character produces the reality of all the promises of God being fulfilled in our life. As we follow after him, God faithfully each day is taking care of us and meeting needs and growing us and showing us who he truly is and revealing to us our inability and our weakness. And he's showing us the value of this alternative path that we think we find ourselves on, but is it God's perfect plan? And so my encouragement to you is to be filled with hope, because that hope does not put us to shame. It'll never leave us disappointed. It'll never leave us unsatisfied. Because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given us. He reinforces all that he is doing through the Holy Spirit. He reinforces that as he's brought this change into our lives, he says to every one of us, I still love you. He says to you who are listening who maybe don't know Jesus Christ, in all these circumstances and all that's going on, I love you. And I am the answer to the challenges and to the anxieties and the tension that we face in these times. Trust the Lord. Look to him. Take advantage of this day. Draw near to the Lord. Use it for him. Learn and grow and exercise the response of faith that God would have us to exercise on this detour that he's put us on for the time being. Let's pray for our nation. Pray for each other. Let's encourage one another. Until next time, be encouraged, and we'll talk to you later.